First, we install the lead pointer. Now we need to find the focal length. We have drawn a square in the software and hatched it. We mark the solid square continuously and move the laser head up and down with lifting pillar. When we see the strongest spark, we stop, then we get the right focal length. This method is a little complicated and slow, so that's why we need this little pointer. In the last video, we introduced the internal red laser. After finding the focal length, we coincide the laser support of external laser pointer with the built-in red laser support. Next time, we only need to make the two laser supports coincide, then the laser is focused. What I want to express is that we use the first method to find the focal length, and then install the laser pointer to help us quickly find the focal length. The method of finding the focal length with an external red laser is not always very accurate. Sometimes the laser pointer moves during transportation, which will cause the two red laser spots to fail to coincide, or the laser is not focused when they are coincident. So we should better know the first method too.